Do you feel like the world is doomed and we're making no progress on climate change? Maybe you think that we're breathing the most polluted air in history, that the best way to reduce your carbon footprint is to eat local food, or the way to end deforestation is to boycott palm oil completely. Now, these are statements that many people believe to be true, but they're wrong. When we step back to look at the data, we see that we are making progress on climate change, just not fast enough. My carbon footprint is much less than my grandparents. I'm breathing the cleanest air in generations. What you eat matters much more than where it's came from. And maybe boycotting palm oil can make deforestation worse, not better. Now, these are headlines that you'll never find in the media, but they do arise when you step back to look at the data. My name is Hannah Ritchie. I'm deputy editor of Our World in Data and a senior researcher at the University of Oxford. And I try to understand the world through data, to look at where we've came from, where we are today, and to understand what the future might look like. It's only by stepping back to look at data that I become much more hopeful that we can address these problems, especially our environmental ones. Now, arguably, there's never been a better time to be alive than today. For most of human history, half of children died before reaching puberty. This is now less than 4%. For most of human history, people lived on the equivalent of less than $2 a day. Now less than 1 in 10 people live there. You can pick any metric from global education to food supplies to life expectancy to human rights and you'll find that the world has become a much better place. Now these changes have become very unequal and we still have a lot of work to do. But we do have the capacity to solve these problems. In many countries, they've already been solved. Now, our environmental metrics are going in the opposite direction. We've all seen the charts of rising CO2, rising temperature, plastic pollution, fertilizer use. The list goes on. Now, when we see these charts, we often feel doomed. I know that I have in the past. We see these lines rising almost exponentially, and we assume that they might never stop. But from stepping back to look at the data, I become much more optimistic that we can turn things around. Air pollution in rich countries is a fraction of what it was in the past. Over the last few decades, carbon emissions in the UK have more than halved. The world grows more than enough food to feed 8, 9, 10 billion people, and it is possible to end deforestation. In my book, Not the End of the World, I go through each of our environmental problems one by one. Using data, I try to lay out where we've came from, where we are today, and importantly, what we need to do next to solve these problems. Now, this book is a call to action. My main point is that these problems are solvable, we are making progress, but we all need to understand and acknowledge this to move things forward. My book, Not the End of the World, is now available to order.